This is our assumption that we please assume. We are dealing with self-fertilized plants. Second assumption, there is no selection for or against the dominant or the recessive gene. And parent generation contains the 1600 individuals and all are heterozygous for the same pair of genes. That means all are heterozygous, that is capital D, small d, genes are there or alleles are there at a particular locus. And number of individuals, 1600. So all are self-fertilized plant. And 1600 individuals liye hain, all are heterozygous for the same locus, that is capital D, small d, and there is no selection. We shall not select anyone. That is, there will be that only self-fertilization will be there for the selfing. So here you see. First column is the generation, second column is the genotypes. There are three genotypes, capital D, capital D, that is homozygous dominant, capital D, small d, that is homozygous, that is heterozygous. This is homozygous. This will be homozygous recessive. So initially, in the first generation, in the best generation, that is we designated as zero generation, you see all are heterozygous. All the 16 individuals are heterozygous, capital D, small d. Okay? And next generation, when there is selfing, that is self-fertilization, the moment self-fertilization is there, so next generation, kya hua? The heterozygous individuals reduced to half. As you know, that is capital T small t is crossed with another capital T small t. So next generation kya hoga? The 1/4 will be capital T, 1/4 will be small t, small t. That means dono milake kitna ho gaya? 50%. And heterozygous kitna hoga? Capital T small t. That is also remain 50%. That is there. So here capital T, or we can say capital T capital, that is 1/4. 1/4 into 1600 is equal to 6400. And 1/4 into 1600 is equal to 400 in the small d. And heterozygous remains kitna? The 50%, that 1600 into half is equal to 800. Again, in the next generation, again, selfing is going on. That is all the heterozygous. 800 will be reduced to half, that is 400 will be heterozygous. Out of 400, that is 1/4, that is 200. 1/4 into 800 is 200 will be the homozygous dominant, that is 200. And the pehle bhi tha kitna tha 400 tha, abhi 200, that is 600. And homozygous recessive also, the 400 tha, 200 a gaya, again 600 ho gaya. And the next generations, out of 400, again selfing is going on. It will be reduced to half, that is 200 will be the heterozygous in the generation 3. And 1/4 of 400, that is 100, will be the homozygous dominant, that is 600 plus 100 is 700, and 100 will be homozygous recessive, that means 600 plus 100 is 700. And in this way, over the generations, if the selfing is going on for 10 generations, the inbreeding homozygosity will be reaches to the 99.999. That means almost 99.9% homozygosity will be there in the 10 generations of self-fertilization. So, and the next column is the percentage of homozygosity. So, in the best proportion, you see all were heterozygous. There was no homozygous, so that's why it is percentage zero. And the moment is the next generation, 50% become heterozygous, 50% becomes homozygous. So as a result, the homozygosity increases by 50%. Again, in the next generation, that is out of 50%, again 50% of the 50 is become homozygous. So ultimately, total percentage of homozygosity become 50% plus 25 is equal to 75%. So in this way, over the generations, homozygosity is increasing. In third generations, homozygosity will be 87.5%. So in this way, the homogeneous percentage of homogeneous city will be increased. Now, what is about the gene frequency? If you see, there are two alleles, that is capital D, small d. So in the base population also, you see that is the 1600 individuals, all are heterozygous, but number of dominant allele is 800 and number of recessive allele is also 800, total 1600. So naturally, that 800 by 1600 is equal to half. So the frequency of capital D gene is 0.5 and frequency of small d, the recessive allele, is also 0.5. In the next generations, F1 generation, you see again, there are 400 capital D. That means the number of dominant alleles kitna hai? Is 402, that is 800. Isme kitna hai? Heterozygous, or that is isme bhi 800 hai. So dono mila ke kitna ho gaya? That is 800 plus 800. That is 50%. So all the times the capital dominant allele will be 0.5 and recessive allele also will be 0.5. So in this way that is, whatever may be the number of generations, that is inbreeding is going on, but the gene frequency still remains same. That means there will be no change of gene frequency. If considering there is no mutation, there is no migration, there is no selection, then the gene frequency remains constant from generation to generation in absence of selection. That we have already seen also in the genetic constitution chapter. That is, if the selection force are not there, not working, then there will be no change of gene frequency. But there will be change of the genotype frequency. So next is the general consequences of inbreeding. Those are the specific consequences. Now the general consequences. So what are the consequences of inbreeding? That is, inbreeding increases homozygosity. It does not change the gene frequency. Inbreeding results into expression of hidden recessive genes in the population by making them homozygous. Yes, this is another important aspect of inbreeding. Suppose that is initially all the individuals were heterozygous, capital D and small d. So the effect of recessive alleles could not be observed in the population, because the effect of the recessive allele was suppressed by the effect of the dominant alleles. The moment the recessive alleles become homozygous, that is homozygous recessive, then if it is the lethal, then it will show the lethal character of the individual. So that's why the inbreeding results into expression of the hidden recessive genes in the population by making them homozygous. Inbreeding fixes characters in an inbred individual, inbred population. Yes, inbreeding, jaise maine bole, capital T, small t population is crossed, and there will be the 1/4 will be capital T, and 1/4 will be small t. So after 20 generations of full inbreeding, the whole population will be divided into the two population only. One population will be homozygous dominant, other population will be homozygous recessive. That means the dominant population, that the dominant characters will be fixed in that population, and the recessive character will be fixed in the recessive population. So that's why the inbreeding fixes characters in an inbred population. At the same time, we can say inbreeding fixes the genes in the population also. That is, the dominant population with dominant genes, the dominant gene is fixed in that population, and the population with the recessive allele, that means the recessive allele is fixed in that population. Next, inbreeding causes inbreeding depression. Yes, these are the very important aspect of the inbreeding, that is decreasing in mean phenotypic value. What is the inbreeding depression? Inbreeding depression ka matlab hai, jab hum inbreeding karenge for few generations, and then there will be increase in the homozygosity. Jab increase homozygosity hoga, dono tarah ka homozygosity increase hoga. The dominant alleles ka bhi homozygosity hoga, and recessive alleles ka bhi homozygosity hoga. Kya? Sahi bol rahe hain? सही बोल रहे हैं. देखो ये फिर इनब्रीडिंग हो रहा है, इसमें कैपिटल डी हो रहा है, इसका भी देखो फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ते जा रहा है. स्मॉल डी इसका भी फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ते जा रहा है ओवर द जनरेशन, ठीक है. एंड हेटेरोजेगस देखो पॉपुलेशन घटते जा रहा है, तो दोनों पॉपुलेशन में दोनों का बढ़ रहा है, ठीक है ना. डोमिनेंट है उसका भी फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ते जा रहा है एंड रिसेसिव उसका भी फ्रीक्वेंसी बढ़ते जा रहा है, ऐसा नहीं है सिर्फ डोमिनेंट बढ़ता है रिसेसिव का नहीं बढ़ता है, वो नहीं दोनों ही बढ़ता है। सो इनब्रीडिंग कॉजेस इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन, सो डिक्रीजिंग इन मीन फ्लोटिंग वैल्यू ऑफ दैट आई मीन टू से दैट इज व्हेन देयर विल बी इनब्रीडिंग सो दैट रिसेसिव एलील्स विल बी एक्सपोज्ड बाय मेकिंग देम होमोजाइगस, है ना। तो होमोजाइगस होगा तो रिसेसिव एलील्स होमोजाइगस रिसेसिव होगा दैट मींस इट विल बी डेलेटेरियस और हार्मफुल टू द कैरियर एंड इट विल नॉट दैट इंडिविजुअल विल नॉट बी एबल टू एक्सप्रेस इट्स कैरेक्टर एज लाइक एज दैट ऑफ द डोमिनेंट इंडिविजुअल। सो एज ए रिजल्ट द टोटल द मीन वैल्यू विल बी रिड्यूस्ड एंड दैट इज द रिडक्शन ऑफ द मीन फेनोटाइपिक वैल्यू ऑफ द इनब्रीड पॉपुलेशन ओवर द बेस्ट पॉपुलेशन इज कॉल्ड इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन। एंड कौन कौन कैरेक्टर में होता है, देखो डिक्रीजिंग इन मीन फेनोटाइपिक वैल्यू ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स एसोसिएटेड विद द फिटनेस रिप्रोडक्शन एंड फिजियोलॉजिकल एफिशिएंसी ड्यू टू इनब्रीडिंग इज नोन एज इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन। ये इसको एकदम कंफर्स कर लीजिएगा, याद कर लीजिएगा, ठीक है ना, एक भी वर्ड मिस नहीं होना चाहिए, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट विल ऑलवेज कम इन द एग्जाम। इसके सारे बहुत सारे सवाल पूछा जाएगा इस डेफिनेशन से। सो डिक्रीजिंग इन मीन फेनोटाइपिक वैल्यू ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स एसोसिएटेड विद द फिटनेस, यू नो व्हाट इज फिटनेस, फिटनेस व्हाट इज फिटनेस, हु कैन से, हु विल से फिटनेस, हु विल से फिटनेस, अरे चेंज ऑफ जीन फ्रीक्वेंसी में पढ़ाया था ना सिलेक्शन में, फिटनेस is the contribution of offspring to the next generation is called fitness of an individual. The individual which is standard or the favored, that is most favored individual, that will more fit means the individual which transmitted, which produces, reproduces maximum number of progeny, that individual will be called more fit. Clear? So that means the character associated with the fitness, reproduction and physiological efficiency due to inbreeding is known as inbreeding depression. So this character, if you know character will be most affected by the inbreeding. You know character ka jo mean fertility value will be decreased drastically due to inbreeding. Next, inbreeding increases prepotency. What is prepotency? See the definition. Prepotency is the ability of an individual to stump up its characteristics to its progeny so that progeny resemble the parents. Yes, inbreeding jab hote hain wo dominant होमोजेगसिटी भी होता है एंड रिसेसिव एलील्स का भी होमोजेगसिटी बढ़ता है। इनके सब डोमिनेंट एलील्स दैट मींस दोज हु आर बिकम कैविटेटिक एबिलिटी दैट इज होमोजेगस टॉल दे आर बिकम द प्योर प्योर दैट मींस दे विल ऑलवेज प्रोड्यूस रिप्रोड्यूस द सेम टाइप ऑफ प्रोजेनी ओवर द जनरेशन। और यू कैन से द रिसेसिव एलील्स दोज हु आर द स्मॉल टी दैट इज ड्वार्फ एनिमल्स और ड्वार्फ प्लांट दे ऑल द टाइम्स दे विल प्रोड्यूस द ड्वार्फ प्लांट बिकॉज दे आर प्योर They have been the gene responsible for dwarfness is fixed and they have become homozygous. So that is called the prepotency. That is the prepotency is the ability of an individual to stump up its characteristics. That is बाप का बेटा बोलता है, हम बोलते हैं ना, दैट मीन्स द फादर पेरेंट्स में जो कैरेक्टर है वो कैरेक्टर एज इट इज वो ऑफस्प्रिंग में आ जाता है, दैट इज द यू कैन से इम्प्रिंटिंग ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द पेरेंट कैरेक्टर्स टू द प्रोजेनी दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रीपोटेंसी। So that means prepotency occurs due to the dominant allele, that is due to the homozygosity of the dominant allele. Prepotency occurs due to homozygosity of the dominant allele. So prepotency is the ability of an individual to stump up its characteristics to its progeny so that progeny resemble the parents. Now use of inbreeding to determine the genetic worth of an individual. Ek individual कितना जेनेटिकली वर्थ है, अच्छे है कि बुरे है, ये सब देखने के लिए हम लोग इनब्रीडिंग यूज करते हैं, दैट इज ए बुल ए सायर बिफोर यूजिंग एज द रिप्रोडक्शन वी मस्ट एग्जामिन वेदर व्हाट इज द वर्थ जेनेटिक वर्थ ऑफ दैट बुल दैट मींस बुल विल बी अलाउड टू फॉर द प्रोजेनी टेस्टिंग। उसका प्रोजेनी टेस्टिंग का जो डॉटर होंगे डॉटर का जो मिल्क प्रोडक्शन का रिकॉर्ड है उसे पता चलता है वो कितने कितने वर्थफुल है। So it should be compared with other bulls also. So to determine the genetic worth of an individual, so inbreeding can be used. It is practical for selection against the recessive gene. If the bull is having possessing some recessive allele, so due to inbreeding, the recessive alleles will be exposed in among the future generations. So if it is some recessive alleles is there, then naturally we shall cull the wool from the population, that wool cannot be used for the breeding purpose. If it carrying some decisive harmful allele, then so inbreeding it can be used for selection against recessive gene. It is used to form the different families and the streams of lab animals. Lab animals that you know are mice, rats, guinea pigs, rabbit, etc., hamster. So it will be used. That is, here in the lab animals, we easily control the inbreeding system, and in that case, we can easily develop the family or the strain of lab animals through the inbreeding. The inbreeding combined with selection over a period of time results into development of new breeds. So, नया breed अगर हमको बनाना है, तो go for the inbreeding and at the same time selection, go for selection over few generations. Then the new breeds can develop. Then inbreeding can be used for production of the prepotent animals. That you know, the most important use of inbreeding is the production of inbred lines. That is the most important aspect of inbreeding, particularly in the plant. In the plant, that is though inbred lines are produced for the wheat production and the rice production, the bumper production ke liye, that is the green revolution jab system aaya tha, Swaminathan jab use kiye the, that is the system that he developed the highly inbred lines of the paddy and the wheat, and those highly inbred lines were crossed together so that they were produced, the bumper production was there. That leads to the green evolution. Similarly, in case of animals, we cannot go for selfing in animals. By what we can go for the parent offspring mating, we can go for the full sisters mating. Then with the help of that mating system, we can increase the homogeneity very rapidly. So, and then if we able to develop the inbred lines, those inbred lines will be allowed to cross together to produce the hybrid production. That is leads to the heterosis or hybrid vigor. That will come to the outbreeding system. So now here, these are the use of inbreeding. So to determine the genetic worth of an individual, it is practiced for selection against the recessive gene. It is used to form different families or strains of lab animals. Inbreeding combined with selection over a period of time results into development of a new breeds. It is used for production of prepotent animals. The most important use of inbreeding is the production of inbred lines. Disadvantage kya hai? So inbreeding increases the frequency of undesirable traits in the population. It exposes lethal and sublethal genes by making them homozygous. And the traits related to fitness, that is survivability, reproduction, physical efficiency, and vigor are reduced in farm and laboratory animals. जब इनब्रीडिंग होगा तो ये जो फिटनेस, जैसे फिटनेस बोला है, रिप्रोडक्शन एंड द फिजियोलॉजिकल एफिशिएंसी, एज वेल एज द वीगर ऑफ द एनिमल्स विल बी रिड्यूस्ड, और द फार्म एनिमल एंड द लेबोरेटरी एनिमल्स विल बी रिड्यूस्ड. सो दीज आर द डिसएडवांटेज. देयर आर थ्री डिसएडवांटेज. दैट इनब्रीडिंग इंक्रीजेस द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ अनडिजायरेबल ट्रेट्स इन द पॉपुलेशन. इट डज नॉट इंक्रीज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ अनडिजायरेबल जीन्स बट रिसेसिव जीन्स, बिकॉज़ यू नो दैट यू हैव सीन दैट इनब्रीडिंग डज नॉट चेंज द जीन फ्रीक्वेंसी. So if you say it increases the frequency of recessive allele, so it will be wrong. So mind it clearly. So this type of very, you know, that complicated questions will come in the exam. Take it on. You just understand very clearly. Base should be very clear. So inbreeding increases the frequency of undesirable traits, not the undesirable genes or the recessive genes in the population. It exposes lethal and sublethal genes by making them homozygous. Homozygous recessive हो जाएगा, lethal का genes का exposure हो जाएगा, lethal character exposure हो जाएगा. Next, the traits related to fitness, as you know, that is called inbreeding depression. Traits related to fitness, that is the survivability, reproduction, and physiological efficiency, all comes under the fitness, and the vigor also. Vigor are reduced. The mean phenotypic value of these characters are reduced due to inbreeding, which is known as inbreeding depression. So these are disadvantage of the inbreeding. So this is all about the inbreeding system. What is inbreeding and the types of inbreeding, the examples of the inbreeding, what are the genetic.
Sir, vigor kya hota hai sir? Vigor. सर लास्ट लाइन आप बता देना सर, द ट्रेट्स रिलेटेड टू द फिटनेस एंड विगर आर रिड्यूस्ड इन द फार्म एंड लेबोरेटरी एनिमल.
विगर विगर बी आई जी ओ यूर. विगर मींस दैट इज एनर्जेटिक, That is, the animals is suppose that very highly energetic, that can able to produce the maximum productivity, but the moment is inbreeding is there, the individual will be homozygous recessive. Homozygous recessive allele cell will be there. So as a result, that all the characters, say for example, that is growth traits. Growth trait will be, there will be stunting growth. If the production, egg production, there will be reduction in egg production. That means that we can say the vigor is lost. ठीक है ना? So these are the disadvantages of the inbreeding. मैंने अभी आपको भेज देता हूँ PPT. उसके बाद आप थोड़ा सा पढ़ लीजिएगा, कोई दिक्कत है तो बताइएगा. ठीक है ना? इसके बाद हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास में करेंगे. What is inbreeding coefficient? How the degree of inbreeding is measured? That is, we shall see. First, this is the basic principles of inbreeding, and then what is the advantage of inbreeding, disadvantage of inbreeding, genetic consequences of inbreeding, and the type of inbreeding. And broadly, it is classified in two categories, that is close breeding and the line breeding. And what are the examples of the close breeding? What are the examples of the line breeding? All you should know. ठीक है ना? Inbreeding is responsible for, if we want to establish the pure line, then inbreeding is the only technique by which we can establish the pure line. Inbreeding is the only technique by which we can fix the character in the population. Inbreeding is the only technique by which we can fix the genes in the population. ठीक है ना? Inbreeding is the technique by which we can select the go for selection against the undesirable genes if present in a wool. So very important this chapter. कोई आप पहले पढ़ लीजिएगा, बस कोई दिक्कत होगा तो बताइएगा. This is the example that I have shown. I have tried to show you, that is, here you see that there is no change of gene frequency, but very often the students say yes, there will be change of gene frequency, and particularly there will be increase the frequency of recessive allele. These are the genetic consequences of inbreeding. Inbreeding increases the homozygosity in the population at the cost of heterozygosity. Means heterozygosity reduce ho jayega, homozygosity badhega. Homozygosity kiska badhega? Self dominant or recessive? Na dono ka? Kiska badhega?
Dono ka. Dono ka sir.
It does not change the gene frequency in the population. All pairs of genes that segregate independently are made homozygous at the same rate. एक पेयर को लेके चलते हैं, उसका जो रेट ऑफ इनब्रीडिंग होगा, जिस रेट पे वो इंक्रीज करता है होमोजेगोसिटी, वो दैट विल बी एप्लीकेबल फॉर द ऑल द इंडिपेंडेंट पेयर ऑफ लोसाई. ठीक है ना? रेट ऑफ इनब्रीडिंग इन केस ऑफ एनिमल्स इज मच स्लोअर देन द प्लांट्स. ओके, बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ प्लांट्स सेल्फिंग इज नॉट पॉसिबल, एंड इनब्रीडिंग कॉजेस फिक्सेशन ऑफ द जीन्स इन द इनब्रीड लाइन. ठीक है ना? में तो बहुत सारे डायग्राम है, मैंने उतना आपको दे नहीं पाया. वीडियो देखना है जिसका जो पेरेंट्स है, दे मस्ट बी रिलेटेड, दे मस्ट बी रिलेटिव्स, देन ओनली वी कैन से दिस इज द इनब्रीड. एंड दैट टू कितने जनरेशन तक होना चाहिए? टू इंडिविजुअल्स आर सेड टू बी रिलेटेड इफ दे हैव कॉमन एंसेस्टर्स इन द प्रीसीडिंग 4 टू 6 जनरेशंस ऑफ देयर पेडिग्री. Why it is limited to 4 to 6 generations? Why not beyond 6 generations? Yes, see, only why 4 to 6 generations? Because if you go for inbreeding for 6 generations, beyond 6 generations, then you'll find that if an ancestor present at 7th generations, it's the genetic material that is letting down or coming down to the to the descendants of the seventh generation, then it will be less than 1%. So common ancestor ka jo percentage of genes will be less than 1% at seventh generation. That's why उसको मना नहीं जाता है. इसलिए बोलते हैं देखो गांव पे अभी भी चलते हैं, जो कोई कुतिया में अगर शादी ब्याह होता है बोलते कि चलो सेवन सात पीढ़ी हो गया मैंने सवा सात जनरेशन हो गया, आप दोनों कुतिया में शादी हो सकता है बच्चे का. दैट मीन्स नाउ देखो वो कॉन्सेप्ट दे डू नॉट नो द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ इनब्रीडिंग, बट स्टिल दैट आई डोंट नो दैट हाउ दैट पीपल ऑफ दैट टाइप they could know all this bad effect of the system. That is, if the marriage takes place very close relatives, then there is every possibility of increase of homozygosity. So homozygosity would be there for the dominant alleles, homozygosity for recessive alleles also there. So if homozygosity, agar recessive alleles ka homozygosity badhta hai, so there is every possibility to expose the lethal character among the progeny. That's why marriage should not be allowed between the relatives. And then ancestors kisko bolte hain, what is descendant, and then what is common ancestor. So these are some terminologies there. What is inbred? The individual which is produced by mating of relatives is known as inbred. What is pedigree? Systematic list of all ancestors to which an individual is genetically related. Now these are some applications of the pedigree. अच्छा आप लोगों को तो दूसरा क्लास हो जाएगा ना? अजला?
Yes sir.
जाओ 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 चलो.
Yes. Yes sir, certainly.
हम इसको ऑफ करते हैं.